Well, it's time for game number 13 in the Indian T20 League. It's between Punjab and Mumbai. These two are the teams that lost the two only super overs that happened in this edition of the tournament. They're both fantastic sides. A rejuvenated Punjab, a completely different looking, a different feel of Punjab that we're getting to watch this season. Rohit Sharma and company have only had one win so far. They've not had great performances, almost pulled off another one, went into the super over versus Bangalore. Both these sides look absolutely fantastic. In this video, I'm going to give you guys all the important numbers, all the facts, the match details that you guys need to know before you start watching the game. Since 2017, both these sides have met each other six times, and four out of those six times, Mumbai have one versus Punjab. But those teams were different. This Punjab side is fantastic. Every single player is contributing. They're doing their job right. They have a new captain in KL Rahul, who's been fantastic at the top of his game, and it's going to be a crackerjack of a contest. Well, let's quickly speak about the venue, because this game is going to be played in the Sheikh Zayed Stadium in Abu Dhabi. It's a fantastic venue to play cricket in. The average first inning score here is around 160-165 of sorts. It's a very good ground to play cricket in. And the teams that have in this edition of the tournament, there have been four games that have been played here. Two teams have won chasing, two teams have lost chasing. So it's a very evenly spaced out ground. It's going to be fantastic between bat and ball. Rohit Sharma on one side, KL Rahul, is going to be a crackerjack of a contest, because these two guys have been dominating my stats chart. That's the next segment of the video. So let's quickly move and discuss that. Well, the first of these numbers is of Rohit Sharma, the captain of Mumbai. This man loves playing against Punjab, has five half centuries, a strike rate of over 140, an average of over 30. He just loves playing against them. 590 odd runs he has versus Punjab. And not just that, the man who lost it for Punjab in the last game, who smacked for 30 runs in an over, Sheldon Cottrell. Rohit Sharma loves playing against Sheldon Cottrell also at the international level, the numbers say so. So that's something that Sheldon Cottrell will have to be wary of, because Rohit Sharma will open the batting and he will go all guns a-blazing. Let's quickly move on to our next one. The next number is about KL Rahul, the skipper of Punjab. This man loves playing against Mumbai, like Rohit Sharma loves playing against Punjab. It's going to be a beautiful contest. The numbers say so, because versus Mumbai, KL Rahul has one century, three half centuries, an average of over 69. That's magnificent. He just loves playing against this side. And the other thing that we need to be wary of here is that KL Rahul also likes playing against Bumrah. He's not an easy customer to get away with, but he's only given his wicket away once to Bumrah in about six innings that he's played against him. So that is something that will have to be taken into consideration for Bumrah, who didn't have a great outing in the last game as such. Moving on and speaking about Kyron Pollard. Well, the year 2020 has not been a great one for everybody, but for Kyron Pollard, it is an exception, because this man has fantastic numbers in this year. He has an average of over 51 in T20 cricket, a strike rate of over 206. That number is magnificent. In the previous game, he almost won it for Mumbai. He scored 60, he was 60 not out of 54 balls. That's something that Mumbai will fancy, because when that man gets going, there's absolutely nobody stopping him. Likewise, Mujib from Punjab, he obviously hasn't had a game so far in this season, but that man in T20s in this year has been fantastic. He's picked up 30 wickets, and that number is magnificent. This considering the fact that there's not been a lot of cricket played. He was fantastic in the CPL also, and most importantly, Sheldon Cottrell, who went away for a lot of runs in the last game, Mujib can replace him. So that is one thing that we will discuss in the probable predicted 11. That is my next segment. Well, let's start with Punjab. This side at the top of the order has KL Rahul, the captain, and Mayank Agarwal, a fantastic opening partnership that these guys had in the last game, followed by Pura and Maxwell, Jimmy Neesham, Sarfraz, Karun Nair. All these guys can absolutely tonk the ball beautifully. In terms of bowlers, they have the youngster Ravi Bishnoi, the leg spinner Murugan Ashwin, who almost won it for them in that last over in the last game. That guy is also a very good one to watch out for. Mohammad Shami is there. And the only weak link that probably they will be looking at is Sheldon Cottrell, maybe replace him with Mujib. I think that might be the only change there. Other than that, Punjab looks a very formidable side. They're a very hard side to beat. Let's quickly move on and discuss the Mumbai side. Mumbai led by Rohit Sharma, the defending champions. They've already been known as slow starters, but this time around they already have a win to their name. So that's something that'll have an advantage over their head. But just not that, they have Pollard back in form. Rohit Sharma is in good nick. Surya Kumar Yadav, Quinton de Kock need to come together. And the most important part is that Bumrah and Hardik Pandya, they've not been themselves off late. So that is probably something that they'll be slightly worried about, but they're world-class players. And if they come good, then Mumbai, like I said before, can again become champions this time also. They have a fantastic leg spinner in Rahul Chahar. That youngster has been doing really well. And if he steps up his game also, Mumbai again will become a very tough side to beat, because it's going to be a contest of two legends of the game already. They're going to be fantastic to watch out for. Let's quickly move on, and before we end the video, I have to tell you guys what Cricktrackers audience has thought about today's game. Well, that would be my predicted 11 for both these sides. In the comments, you guys let me know what your predictions are going to be. And before I finish the video, I'm going to have to ask you guys another question. A question that I already asked the Cricktracker audience, for which I have an answer. That question was, will you guys think if Mumbai will be able to pin Punjab down, because both these sides are raring to go. And surprisingly, considering the form that Punjab is in, 61% of the people went against Punjab and said yes, Mumbai can do it, and only 39% are supporting Punjab to go and win this contest. I don't know what the number games are, but it is very clear that it's going to be a competition to watch out for. So this is what Cricktrackers audience has decided. So ladies and gentlemen, if you guys like the video, hit the like button. In the comments, do let me know what your predictions are, who you think is going to win this game. And if you already haven't done it, then hit that subscribe button, also the notification bell right next to it. And I will see you guys very soon with another video.